Say the fight over voting rights in Texas started with the late Willie Velasquez. He created the Southwest Voter Registration Education Project. It actually began in 1974 right here in San Antonio. Jesse DeGarriato with a look back.
Latinos know whoever they're voting for stands a chance of winning, or maybe not, but at one time.
Even if all the Latinos came out to vote, they wouldn't be able to get elected because the system was rigged.
Longtime attorney Rolando Rios took on gerrymandering and at-large voting alongside the late civil rights pioneer Willie Velasquez, who founded the Southwest Voter Registration Education Project.
He got people registered, but then he realized registration is not enough.
Single-member city council districts are just one example of the lawsuits they won.
What do you think Willie Velasquez would be saying now?
Right now, Willie would be at the leadership table in Washington with our state reps.
More than 50 House Democrats who've left Texas and the Texas House of Representatives without a quorum to take up bills they say will make it harder for people to vote. The bills, a result of the U.S. Supreme Court gutting Section 5 of the Voting Rights Act in 2013. Up until then, any election changes in Texas had to be pre-cleared by the federal government. Rios says the justices had decided.
It's been a long time. The states have a right to run their elections however they want.
Rios says San Antonio and other major Texas cities now may have more Latinos in leadership, but when asked if that means the fight is over,
it's not.
Judging, he says, by what's happening in Austin and in Washington. Jesse DeGollado, KSAT 12 News.